गुड आफ्टरनून सर।
गर्ल्स गुड आफ्टरनून। मा सर हैज नॉट जॉइंड आई थिंक। गुड
गुड आफ्टरनून मैम। गुड आफ्टरनून मैम।
आफ्टरनून। गुड आफ्टरनून मा। FNZC girls, FNZC girls, hello,
यस
you are enjoyed this class ma?
यस मैम।
Okay.
यस मैम।
कोई राग पो
Okay, good afternoon everybody, and welcome to today's session. Shall we start the session, madam?
Yes, sir.
Okay, madam is not there. Rajini madam garu, Manjula madam
garu. Yes, ma'am left, sir.
Okay, no problem. So within a minute we will start the session. I will share the screen. This slide is visible, Amma. This slide is visible.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Welcome.
Sir, good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon, madam. Good afternoon. Shall we continue, madam?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Please start the recording. Okay, I hope this slide is visible.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so today we are going to discuss about edible mushroom. No, history. This is our completed yesterday class. I will take another slide. Okay. Okay, edible mushrooms and poisonous mushroom. Today we are going to discuss. Am I audible? Shall we continue?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, today we are going to discuss about edible and poisonous mushrooms. So how many types of the edible mushrooms and how many types of the poisonous mushrooms we will going to explain today. So fast growing basidiomycetes fungi. Mushrooms are belongs to which class, Amma? Anybody? You have already studied in your first year, first semester, fungi. Mycology, fungus, fungi. According to Ainsworth classification, you are already studied about the class. Which class? Mushrooms belongs to which class? Basidiomycetes. Which class, Amma? Basidiomycetes. Basidiomycetes. Okay, Basidiomycetes fungi. Basidiomycetes fungi. And this fruiting produces fleshy fruiting body. Mushrooms are produced fleshy fruiting body, So this is fleshy fruiting bag. So this is the pileus, the fleshy fruiting body. Maybe button-like or fan or umbrella shape. So this is in white button or button shaped or fan shaped, even though umbrella shape, umbrella shape. So they are characterized by having heterotrophic mode of nutrition. So all fungi are heterotrophs, why? Anybody can tell why these mushrooms are heterotrophs? Anybody? Because these mushrooms are belongs to fungi. They don't have any chloroplasts or chlorophylls, pigments, So chloroplasts are not present. They are not synthesized the food material by themselves. That's why all fungi, including mushrooms also, they are nutritionally, they are heterotrophic living organism. Heterotrophic living organism. Am I clear? Then these mushrooms have high protein value. Okay, the protein content is rich. Protein value is compared to other fungi. These mushrooms are rich in protein, other accessory compounds. Along with the protein, some of the accessory compounds like amino acids and essential amino acids, not all amino acids, essential amino acids, lysine, okay, and even though vitamin D also available in these mushrooms. Along with this vitamin D, some of the nutrients like phosphorus, sulfur, so this type of micronutrients also present in this pileus or gills of the mushroom. Then nutrients in mushroom. How many types of the nutrients are mushrooms in the edible mushrooms? Generally, all mushrooms generally all mushrooms are low in sodium, fat and calories. So this is the most important of the cardiovascular disease patients.
Slides are not visible, sir.
Okay, Amma. Okay.
Only file is there.
Okay. Now?
No, sir.
Okay, sorry, Amma. Sorry. What's the problem? Now it's visible, Amma?
No, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, edible mushrooms. Okay, mushrooms are, looks like a variety of the mushrooms images we are observed in this slide. Okay, and edible mushrooms is very useful and safe to pick and good to eat. So this is about what we have discussed here. So these are fast-growing basidiomycetes fungi mushrooms belongs to, and these mushrooms produce fleshy fruiting body, maybe button-like or fan-like or umbrella-like structures. Button-like, umbrella-like or fan-like structure of the shaped fruiting body we are observed. This is the fan shape or umbrella-shaped structure we are observed in this image. They are characterized by having heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Why? Because they don't have chlorophylls or chloroplasts. That's why the mushrooms are heterotrophic nature. And these mushrooms high protein value and other accessory pigments like essential amino acids. This slide is visible. Now,
yes, sir.
Nutrients in mushrooms. Okay, so which type of nutrients are available in mushrooms? Then low sodium content and fat even though calories. So that's why then high BP persons and hypertension persons, even though the other patients who suffered from cardiovascular diseases, that patients also very easy to consume with mushrooms. Why? Because they contain low sodium, fat and calories. So that's why they are very useful. And just about 20 calories in a cup, high in fiber and protein. So fiber content is very, very useful in the all type of the living organism. Any, even though human beings or animals, fiber content is very useful for the in the metabolic activities and even the digestion tract. Then 20 to 30% of the protein by dry weight. So that's why these mushrooms use as a single cell protein. So rich in the mineral minerals like potassium, selenium, copper, zinc and magnesium. Oyster mushroom rich in iron too. So iron is nowadays, what is the use of iron? Anybody can tell me? What is the use of iron? So if iron deficiency we are observed in the human beings, which type of disease you going to observe?
Anemia, sir.
Very good. I'm excellent. So anemia. So that's why iron is necessary for the human beings, for the production of the blood. So that's why the blood is produced with the help of iron content. Iron is in the part of the heme or hemoglobin. So heme is in the center part of the heme structure, though iron is necessary. So that's why the content of the hemoglobin, this iron is necessary. So this iron is present in which mushroom, Mama? Which mushroom? Oyster mushroom. What is the scientific name of oyster mushroom? Yesterday we discussed, you know. Oyster. What is the scientific name of oyster mushroom? Pleurotus sojer kaju, you know. So yesterday we already discussed it, na? Oyster mushroom. Pleurotus sojer kaju. So this rich along with this vitamin D and iron. Okay. Then B complex vitamins like riboflavin, B3, niacin, B5 and pantothenic acid also, B9. So these are the B complex vitamins are present in the mushrooms, and the only vegetable or fruit for that matter that produce vitamin D when in sunlight and is a source of natural vitamin D. So that's why vitamin source of natural vitamin D is available in mushrooms. And rich in L-ergothionine, a powerful antioxidant. So antioxidants are very, very useful for fight against the microbes and also the harmful toxins in our body. So antioxidants are very, very important. So whenever the free radicals are generated in the inside the body, this antioxidant is going to destroy the free radicals. So that's why the antioxidants, whenever, even though all vegetables contain antioxidants, remember, even the fruits. So my dear friends, I am saying that each vegetable and each vegetables are like a medicine. So they are treated as a medicine, then only our body is going to be healthy, very healthy. So healthy person may be wealthy. If the wealthy person does not have healthy, then automatically he became a patient or and lost everything. Okay, so that's why health is very, very important. And rich in cancer fighting nutrient like polysaccharides and linoleic acid. So linoleic acid is a what we can say that linoleic acid is a fat, you know, then useful fat, useful
omega 3 and omega 6 fatty acids.
Yeah, yeah, very good, very good, very good. So linoleic acid is a one of the useful fatty acids. So these polysaccharides and fatty acid is very useful, and these are against the fight against the cancer. So carcinogenic agent, any carcinogen or carcinogenic agent inside the body, then this useful linoleic acid and these polysaccharides are useful to fight against that carcinogenic agent, and free of cholesterol. So zero cholesterol is very, very necessary for the cardiovascular disease person, and contain triterpenes, so terpenoids, so secondary metabolites like terpenes, you know, terpenes. So these terpenes are also present in inhibits histamine release and are anti-inflammatory. It is used as a anti-inflammatory nature. Then edible mushrooms. In this, edible mushrooms are fleshy edible. We have already discussed it, you know, fruiting body, and according to Chang and Hayes, so the scientists, they are classified of these mushrooms. They can appear either below ground, that is hypogeous, and even above ground, epigeous. We are already discussed in first class of our course, and where they may be picked by hand. And edible mushrooms are consumed for their nutritional value, and they are occasionally consumed for their supposed to medicine value. So this is a wonderful pictures related to Agaricus bisporus, you know. So Agaricus bisporus, we can also call as white button or button mushroom. Am I right? Table mushroom, cultivated mushroom, and champignon mushroom. Am I right? So these are the common names, other alternate names for this Agaricus bisporus. Agaricus bisporus is the scientific name, but the common names of the different regions or area or in the regional name, that is the common mushroom, button mushroom, white button, cultivated mushroom, table mushroom, whatever, the champignon mushroom. Okay, these are edible. The basidiomycetes mushroom native to all grasslands, especially in Europe and North America, and they may grow in on the soil or in other food secure also. In China, it is the largest producer edible mushrooms, according to over 50% of the world's edible mushroom production. Compared to other mushroom, 50% of the mushrooms is occupied by this Agaricus bisporus. Am I right? This light is visible. The next point is the oyster mushrooms. You know, oyster. That is the golden oyster mushroom. The scientific name of golden oyster mushroom is the Pleurotus soldier kaju, or another species, that is the Pleurotus citropiletus. Piletus or piletus. Okay. So this is also edible gild fungus, and is one of the most popular wild edible mushroom compared to white button. Okay, then grow in cluster of bright yellow to golden brown caps with a velvety dry surface texture. Why we can say that velvety means a makmal cloth, you know, the smooth surface of the cloth when we are touching the we are experiencing very smooth nature. So that's why the cap of the pileus or cap or the gills area, when we are going to touch the we are experiencing very smooth nature. That is the volvetti. We can also call volvetti or dry surface texture. Yes, sir. Anybody? Is there any doubt, ma? Then caps range 20 to 65 millimeter range. The diameter. The flesh is thin and white with a mild taste and without strong smell. Okay. Then the gills are white, closely spaced and round down the stem. The spores are cylindrical or elliptical in shape, smooth, haline, amyloid, and measure 6 to 9 by 2 to 3.5 micrometer range. Then the third one is the Wolveriella volvacea. So this also we can call as a Pedestra mushroom or straw mushroom. So previous mushroom we can also call as oyster mushroom, you know, golden oyster mushroom or oyster mushroom. The first one is the button mushroom or white button. The second one is the pleurotus sojourn god belongs to oyster mushroom, the golden oyster mushroom. The third one is the Wolveriella volvacea. This Wolveriella volvacea we can call as a Pedestra mushroom or a straw mushroom, you know. So it is a species of edible mushroom cultivated east and southeast Asia and used extensively in Asian cuisines and cuisines. Okay, then they are often available fresh in Asia, but are more frequently found in canned or dried forms outside their nation of cultivation. Even though Asian countries and out of the countries, they are also available in the dry condition, you know. Then straw mushroom are grown on rice straw beds. Okay, so the paddy straw or rice straw beds, they are used as a substrate for the growing of the Wolveriella volvacea or paddy straw mushroom, and they are adaptable and take 4 to 5 days to mature and are most successfully grown in subtropical climates with high annual rainfall. So the habitat of this Wolveriella volvacea is subtropical climate with high annual rainfall is very suitable for the growing of this Wolveriella volvacea or Pedestra mushroom. And along with this common edible mushrooms are the white button that we can call as Agaricus bisporus. We have already discussed it. This is looks like a white, a creamy white or pale tan color, you know. So these mushrooms have a firm structure and a delicate flavor. They are juicy, tasty, and inexpensive. They can be grilled or mixed with other mushrooms, can also be stuffed and baked, you know. So these we are observed in the supermarkets. That is the white button or button mushroom. Am I right? That is the scientific name of that white button is Agaricus bisporus. The next one is the chanterella. The scientific name of that chanterella, that is the Chantharellus siberis, that is related to Russian. Siberia means Russia, you know. So Siberia is the region of the Russia. So that is a very cold region of the Russia, and the Siberian cranes are migrated from Siberia to in our erstwhile Andhra Pradesh, or now Andhra Pradesh, Kolleru and Pulikata Lake, you know. Are you heard about the term Pulikata and Kolleru Lake in Andhra Pradesh? Nellore region, Nellore district. Kotte Srikamulu, Nellore district. Am I right? Okay. Then this Cantharella formosus, the medium texture mushroom with the fruity aroma. So why? Because these are all related to Asian countries, you know. So Russia belongs to Asia and Europe. Remember, my dear friends, Russia is the both the continents. Some of the area related to Europe, some of the area related to Asia. That is the beauty of the Russia. That is the variation among the different continents. And the color ranges from pale white to yellow to orange and the brown to black color. We are observed this Chantharella or Cantharella. And it has wrinkles on the underside instead of gills. Then the next one is the oyster mushrooms, that is the Pleurotus oysterus or Pleurotus sojourn. You know. So it has a velvety like structure. So velvet cloth, makmal cloth, are you ever seen, are you ever touched, are you ever experienced? Makmal cloth or velvety cloth? No. But you observed, but didn't recollect the information. No problem. So these velvety or makmal structure the is a trumpet shaped with color ranging from gray to pale brown to reddish caps on a gray white stem. It has a mild safe taste compared to white button. It has a mild safe seafood taste. Seafood means seafood, you know, the prawns, fishes. Okay, so seafood, number of varieties are there now. The coastal regions, they are intaking of the food material every day. They are taking seafood. Then Portobello is another species of the Agaricus bisporus. Then it has the big large umbrella like cap. The structure and taste is steak like it is buttery soft. And shiitake related to, you know, Japan mushroom, you know, shiitake mushroom, that is the Lentinula edodus, Lentinula or Lentinula edodus. So the color of its cap range from tan to dark brown. Tan means black color, remember my dear friends. It has an earthy and a smoky flavor and taste best when cooked. Whenever we are cooking this shiitake mushroom, the flavor is very enjoyable, and it is low in water content compared to white button or butter mushroom or Agaricus bisporus. This shiitake mushroom is low water content. And the next one is the crimini or keremini. The crimini is related to another species of the Agaricus bisporus, and this is actually the immature portobello, you know. So this is portobello, you know. The portobello, Agaricus bisporus. The crimini is actually related to immature portobello. This resembling the white button mushroom or white mushroom with a firmer texture and deeper flavor. Okay, so actually white it is very related to white button or button mushroom flavor. The cap can be from a pale to tan to rich brown color. And the next one is the enokitake mushroom. Amma, are you follow? Are you feel bored?
No, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So you are very familiar with these words. That's why I am moving very fast. Otherwise, I will slowly explain. No problem. Enokitake mushroom is another type of mushroom. That is the scientific name is Flomillina velupita. Flomillina velupitae. Velupitaes or velupitae. Then a mild flavored crunchy structure, that is a mushroom with a fruity taste. The next one is the porcini. Porcini is the common name, that is the scientific name is the Boletus edulis. So Boletus edulis, it is a rich woody flavor, and the cap can be roasted like the portobello, that is a white button mushroom, like, you know, and it can be diced and cooked. It can be also added raw to salad. Okay. Without cooking, it is also added salad also. Then morel. So this is one of the most important mushroom type, that is also we can call it as Morchella angusticeps. Morchella angusticeps, very, very important. Remember, my dear friends, and competitive exam also, they are asking morel or Morchella. Morel is also we can call as Morchella angusticeps. These Morchella angusticeps are Morchella esculenta. So these are related to morels. And these are the Basidiomycetes fungi and related to mushrooms, remember. And it is considered a delicacy. It has a deep and clean flavor. It can be toxic if eaten raw and should therefore be cooked. It can be cooked with non-fat cream sauces and taste best with just a little amount of butter. So that's why this is a very, very tasty. And remember, my dear friends, compared to other mushrooms, this morel or Morchella is high cost value. And then black tuffles. So the tuffles also are the type of species. The scientific name of tuffles, the tuffles is a tuber melanosporum or tuber magnatum. These are the two species. It has a sweet, musky and pungent flavor. So beautiful terminology you listen, Amma. So it is a sweet, musky and pungent flavor. Okay, then the next important mushrooms are the poisonous mushrooms. So regarding of this edible mushrooms, these are the edible mushrooms, you know, then black truffles, morel, polisini, there is a boletus edulis and inokitake and sirimini or kirimini, aragaricus bisporus and shiitake and portobello and oyster, chanterella and white butter. These are all edible mushrooms, you know. Along with edible mushrooms, we are going to discuss about the poisonous mushrooms. So poisonous mushrooms, see here, are you absorbed, Amma? Are you absorbed? The edible mushrooms are very common color, you know, white color or brown color. But remember, my dear friends, the poisonous mushrooms are very beautiful colors, you know. So what you observed, Amma? The harmful substances are even the living being, just like a colorful, then external appearance is very colorful. So in lower classes, we have already studied about the Merchant of Venice, you know, all that glitters are not gold. Am I right? In English terminology, Socrates written, I hope Socrates or English, Shakespeare written that all that glitters are not gold, or all that glitters is not gold. Ante emanattu merisedanta bangaram kaadu. Am I audible, my dear dosto?
Yes,
are you feel bore? Are you feel bore? Are you feel bore?
Okay.
Yes, sir. Okay. Then poisonous mushrooms. So looks like a very attractive and beautiful color and charming color, you know. So these are the poisonous mushrooms. Okay. These mushrooms, the poisonous mushrooms, also known as the mycetism or mycetismus. Okay, this poisoning of mushrooms we can also known as mycetism. So nowadays, what we heard about the present fungal disease, black fungus, yellow fungus, am I right?
Yes, sir.
White fungus. So that is caused by? That is caused by mucor, okay, mucor mucosis, okay, mycosis, okay. Sir, in the classroom, no, 2 minutes tarvata chestha sir, aragantha alledi 2 nimisham tarvata. Right, mucor mycosis, you know, mycosis. So that's why, so here the mushroom, the poisoning of the mushroom poisoning also known as the mycetism, you know. So mycetism or mycetismus. Then refers to a harmful effects from ignition of a toxic substance present in a mushroom. These symptoms can vary from slight gastrointestinal and discomfort to death. What we observed in this sentence, Amma? Whenever we are intaking of these toxic mushrooms or poisonous mushrooms, the first symptoms we are slightly absorbed gastrointestinal diseases or problems. So gastrointestinal means digestion problems, you know, food poisoning internally. And the toxins present are secondary metabolites and produced by the fungi. So why this gastrointestinal discomfort and going to death? Why? Because the fungi or the mushroom, they are release the secondary metabolites into their body. The toxins are related to secondary metabolites. Am I right? The most common reason for this misidentification is close resemblance in terms of color and general morphology of the toxic mushroom species with edible species. My dear friends, remember, both the mushrooms are looks like morphologically they are looks like very closer, but the important thing is which one is the edible and which one is the poisonous mushroom. We are not only identified with our naked eye. That's why very, very important and also very dangerous of these mushrooms. Remember, my dear dosto, where the poisonous mushrooms are the turns either green or purple color. But remember, the edible mushroom does not strain green or purple color. So the colorful mushrooms are always, remember, harmful mushrooms or poisonous mushrooms. Am I clear?
Yes.
Is it follow or not? Yeah. So then when you taste a piece of mushroom, it burns and stings the tongue. బోన్స్ అండ్ థింగ్స్ ఆఫ్ ద టంగ్ నాలుక పైన ఉండేటువంటి ఆ రుచి గురికలు మండినట్టు కనిపిస్తుంది వెన్ ఎవర్ యు ఆర్ ఈట్ దిస్ పాయిజనస్ మష్రూమ్ బట్ ద ఎడిబుల్ మష్రూమ్ వెన్ ఎవర్ యు ఆర్ టేకింగ్ ద పీస్ ఆఫ్ ది ఎడిబుల్ మష్రూమ్ దిస్ ఎక్స్పీరియన్స్ యూ డి నాట్ యు అబ్జర్వ్ దెన్ పాయిజనస్ మష్రూమ్స్ హ్యావ్ బ్యాడ్ ఒడోర్ బ్యాడ్ ఒడోర్ ఒడోర్ మీన్స్ స్మెల్ యు నో ఒడోర్ మీన్స్ స్మెల్ ఒడోర్ మీన్స్ స్మెల్ సో బట్ edible mushrooms it has a sweet taste whenever you are purchase from the more shop or heritage shop my beloved brother JK Tirupati sir is there you are visible very nearer to his home heritage shop is there so number of packets are there edible mushroom that is the white button mushrooms so whenever we are going to purchase when you open the packet the odor is smell is very sweet taste you know so that's why I experience it very lot you know so okay then compared to the spices mushrooms the taste is the bitter taste and edible mushrooms are sweet sweet taste remember and there is no in poisonous mushroom there is no presence of worms but there is a presence of worms and there is a presence of scales on the cap so cap shows about the scales ups on the outside of the cap are pileus contain scales okay the scale like appearances we are observed on the surface of the pileus or cap but the edible mushroom does not possess the scales on the cap see here the cap contain the scales you know different this is the cap the cap contain the number of scales you know పులుసు లాంటి నిర్మాణాలు వీటి పైన ఉన్నాయి చూడండి ఈ చత్రిక అనేటువంటి నిర్మాణం పైన సో ది స్కేల్స్ ఆర్ ఐడెంటిఫైడ్ వెదర్ దిస్ ఇస్ ఎ పాయిజన్ మష్రూమ్ ఆర్ నాట్ ఐ క్లియర్ సో దాట్ నెక్స్ట్ దెన్ డెత్ క్యాప్ సో వెరీ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్ మరణ మకుటం అంటారు దీన్ని మరణ మకుటం డెత్ క్యాప్ క్యాప్ అంటే మకుటం మరణ మకుటం సో దిస్ ద డెత్ క్యాప్ సైంటిఫిక్ నేమ్ ఇస్ అమానిటా ఫాలాయిడస్ అమానిటా ఫాలాయిడా వెరీ వెరీ డెత్ the highly poisonous mushroom is amanita species amanita phalloides amanita virosa amanita muscaria so these are the species related to poisonous mushrooms this death cap or amanita phalloides they are grown in the season from july to november am I clear am I audible are you follow
Yes, sir.
This slide is visible. Amanita phalloides.
Yes, sir.
Right. Very good. Then what are the symptoms when we are taking of the intaking of this Amanita phalloides or death cap? So start several hours after some time. Are you recollect the information? One cinema. I have already remember. You know that cinema, that movie, Telugu cinema. What movie? Endukante Premata. Okay. So the picture. One heroine intaking the beautiful mushroom and she's going to what we can say fell down unni meeru chusi untaru aa cinema right then after several hours it begins with severe vomiting and diarrhea okay even though stomach pains then follows what appears to be a full recovery a few days later definitely they will going to die of the kidney or liver failure my dear friends the critical organs are important organs are the largest organs largest glands of our body is the liver you know so that is the 1.5 kg weight you know that's liver so liver function is never forgettable because whenever we are intaking of the food material whatever food packet material you are intaking whenever we are taking the juice okay our Rajini madam yesterday she told me so she is intaking of the juice you know so whenever we are intaking the juice or food material whatever it may be that first reaches the liver so liver is the watchman of the house okay intiki oka watcher oka watchman ledha oka office ki watchman ela untado mana body lo jarigetundi metabolic activities though in our body the all metabolic activities is controlled or not controlled that is supervised by this liver so liver is very very important and also one more thing the liver can be have capacity to recover or rejuvenate. So that is the most important. I mean the kidney. So both the organs are going to fail you. Definitely they will go to die. So this mushroom has caused the most recorded fatalities in the UK. There is no known antidote. Remember, till today, there is no medication. In better these cases observed in the UK, Britain. Okay. Then the second one is the destroying angel. Destroying angel. And the entity? Nashana Devata in Telugu. Ematam? Nashana Devaduta. Leda Nashana Devata. Destroying angel. Amanita virosa. So this Amanita virus also compared to same Amanita phalloides, that the growing season is July to November. So one of the our dosto is asking me, sir, why this Amanita phalloides, Amanita virus can grow the season July to November? Why? Because that the time is the moisture and rainfall season. So that's why the moisture and rainfall is very suitable for growing of these mushrooms. Am I right? And what are the symptoms of the destroying angel or Amanita virosa? The symptoms, the start several hours after eating. It begins with the severe vomiting and diarrhea and stomach pains. Like that same Amanita phalloides. And then follows what appears to be a full recovery. A few days later, you will die of kidney and liver failure. Am I clear? So what you observed in these both slides are both images? Because death cap and destroying angel both are growing the same season and the symptoms are same, or there is no variation, so both are same, even though the critical organs like kidney and liver is going to fail you and causing death. And the third one is the Amanita pantherina, that we can call as panther cap. What we can say that panther cap, see here panther cap, how it's look like. So how is it look like? So this is panther cap. So this is the growing season also from July to November. So, like Amanita phalloides, Amanita virosa. So both are equal to the compared to the panther cap or Amanita pantherina. Amanita pantherina. So what are the symptoms observed whenever intaking of this Amanita pantherina? So intense sickness as well as vivid hallucinations. Hallucinations. Are this term ever heard? Anybody? Hallucinations.
Yes, sir.
Which movie? Brahmananda has tells na which movie? Idiot. Arya. Arya hallucination. First stage of hallucination. Third stage of hallucination means Brahmalo kelipodam anamata. Brahma padtam anamata. Anni manaku hallucinations ganapadthayi. Anni vitta chitralu ganapadthayi anamata. So that's we can call as hallucinations, you know. so that is the best experience. Are you ever heard this term? In the only we are observed on the movie, but in day-to-day life activity we didn't observe. I hope no problem. That is not a matter. Next, the next one is the fly agaricus. Fly agaricus means egre. Emantam dinni flying fox antam. Egre nakka. Flying fox or flying agaricus, the flying cap and kodavilsam, egre topi, egre chatram and kodavilsam. This Amanita muscaria, the scientific name of fly agaricus, that is Amanita muscaria. These are the four species are very dangerous. Amanita phalloides, Amanita virosa, Amanita pantherina, Amanita muscaria. So the compared to Amanita phalloides, Amanita virosa, Amanita pantherina, the muscaria is growing season is August to December. So this is the variation among these four Amanita species. And what are the symptoms we are observed whenever intaking of this flying agaricus, that is the Amanita muscaria? Vary between patients. They range from nausea or twitchiness or drowsiness and to delirium or even the seizures and coma, going to coma. And definitely they will go into death. So that's why these are the four Amanita species are very dangerous to what we can say that our living organism. Okay, then deadly web cap. Deadly web cap. That is the Cartinarius and Rubellus. Cartinarius, Rubellus. That is the scientific name. The growing season is August to November. same like agarista agaric sorry amanita muscaria. So this is the like this, okay, August to December. See here, August to November, this is the growing season. And the symptoms when we are intaking of this poisonous food, poisonous mushroom, that is the fool's web cap, the fool's web cap. And the web caps contains a poison called urelanin. Urelanin is the chemical component, okay, and which is very long lasting. Okay, then the next one is the fool's web cap. Fool's web cap. So that is the also species related to Cartinarius. That is the Cartinarius urelanus. Urelanus. This is rubellus. This is urelanus. This is also the growing season is August to November, and the symptoms when we are intaking of this fool's web cap, this is the deadly web cap and this is the fool's web cap, and starts with the flu-like symptoms, okay, respiratory symptoms, and then proceed to renal failure. Renal failure, that is the unquenchable thirst, that is the frequent urination and kidney pain, okay. Then the next one is the bolitis stannosus, bolitis satanas. That is, we can call it Satan's boliet. This growing season is, see, this is the Satan's boliet, and the Satan's boliet growing season is June to September, and the symptoms are nausea, diarrhea, and vomiting of hours, and the thought it isn't usually fatal. And the next one is the ivory funnel. Ivory funnel. So this, the scientific name of this ivory funnel is Clitocybe blanchi or blanchi. So this Clitocybe blanchi or blanchi growing season is July to early December. The symptoms also known as the sweating mushroom. Eat too much and the symptoms will increase to sickness, vomiting, and diarrhea. Okay. Then the next one is the fool's funnel. Fool's funnel, that is the Clitocybe rivulosa. So earlier one is the ivory funnel, that is the Clitocybe blanchi, and this is the fool's funnel, that is Clitocybe rivulosa, shows about the grown in the July to early December. The symptoms, excessive salivation and sweating after half an hour. If lots of the mushroom is eaten, then you could be facing intense cyclic diarrhea and stomach pain. So actually, the little bit of these mushrooms are intaking, there is not impact on the human or impact on the health condition, but too much of eating, so some of the symptoms we are observed in the diarrhea or sickness, even though intense sickness and stomach pain also. Then the next one is the fool's consae. Okay, fool's cone cap or cone cap or cone, fool's cone cap. That is the scientific name of this Conocybe filaris. This growing season is the Conocybe filaris. The scientific growing season is June to October. The symptoms, like many of the most poisonous mushrooms on this list, the fool's cone cap contains amatoxins. The worst symptom is the liver failure. Okay, then so this is the poisonous mushrooms and their effect of humans. So the slide shows about which type of toxins they are affecting, which type of symptoms we are observed. So first one is the alpha amanitin. So that is the toxin. Level of toxin is very deadly. Definitely death has occurred. So what is the effect of after consume? So liver damage is within the 3 days, and even though injection and the principal toxin in genus Amanita. Then phallotoxin, that is non-lethal. Mainly the impact on the what we can say, that elementary canal, that is a gastrointestinal upset, that is found in the poisonous Amanitas. Then Urelanin, that is a deadly, definitely death has occurred. So these are the some of the poisonous mushrooms and their effects. Okay. And this is the classification related to some of the species. Okay. So the amatotoxin containing mushroom species, that is Amanita, Lepiota and Galerina and Conocybe filaris, these are all having amatotoxin containing mushroom species. And the amatotoxins include at least 9 different toxins, that is alpha, beta, gamma and theta amanitins and amanulin and amanulinic acid and amanin amide, this amanin and androporamanulin. So these are the toxins along with this amanotoxins, 9 different toxins. The amanotoxins are selectively inhibitors of RNA polymerase. What their impact on the living organism? So the RNA polymerase, which are critical enzymes required for the synthesis of mRNA, that is, we can call it as from DNA to mRNA, we can call as transcription, you know, and our microRNAs. So that is mRNA or microRNA. And amatotoxins can be measured directly in the serum and urine of poisoned patients. Whenever the poisonous patients, they are taking the their serum of the urine extract or urine, they are easily identified. And the enzyme linked, so ELISA test, you know, enzyme linked immunosorbent assay, that is ELISA test. Are you heard about the ELISA test, amma? Anybody? ELISA test ane padam vinnara meer eppudana? ELISA.
Yes, sir.
ELISA, enzyme linked immunosorbent assay. It is a protein test, you know. So this is identified identification of the virus test, that is the HIV virus, you know, AIDS virus. Am I right? ELISA.
Yes,
and
sir.
This this ELISA and the gas chromatography. Are you heard about the chromatography? Paper chromatography.
Yes, sir.
High liquid pressure chromatography. High pressure liquid chromatography. So different chromatography also there now. Diagnosis experiments or diagnosis tests are useful for the identification of this amatotoxins. That is number one, enzyme linked immunosorbent assay. Okay, this is enzyme linked immunosorbent assay. The next one is a gas chromatography and mass spectrometry. So digital telephone images. These are all useful for the detecting of these poisonous mushrooms or amatotoxins or harmful toxins. So these are the Lepito. So Lepiota, the Brunoni carnata. We are easily identified with our what we can say, the cattle dung, you know. Pashula pentala kuppala paina manam chustam chudandi. Lepiota, Brunoni carnata. Am I right? If you choose, are you ever seen these images?
Yes,
so Galerina marginata and Amanita phalloides. So you are already watched, absorbed, but the scientific name or the name you are unable to detect or identify. But these are also they are absorbed in the our natural surroundings. And edible Amanita species are Amanita lanae, very, very important. I'm a competitive examination question. Actually, all Amanita species are harmful or very poisonous mushrooms. But the one edible Amanita mushroom species, that is Amanita lanae. Okay, Amanita lanae. Actually, Amanita species are very, very dangerous, very poisonous mushrooms or very poisonous fungi. But Amanita lanae is the one and only one species that is edible mushroom. Okay, then Conocybe filaris. So only in silymarin and polymyxin B have demonstrated some antidotal effectiveness in patients with Amanita phalloides poisoning. That is a detecting experiment, you know. So this is the Amanita muscaria and Amanita what we can say, that the different chemical components, you know, muscarin and muscarin, okay, then acetylcholine. So this acetylcholine is a neurotransmitter, you know, acetylcholine and allomuscarin, allo muscarin and L plus or L plus or minus muscarin. So these are all the chemical component of the Amanita muscaria. So this American Association for the Advancement of Science, according to there, they are identified different chemical components. Okay, so this is the mushroom anatomy. You are already know about this information. Okay, toxic mushrooms and the toxic groups. Okay, thank you. If you have any doubt, please ask me, Amma. This is the session for your doubts or any queries. Interaction session. Anybody? No.
Excuse me, sir. Sir, one study classifications.
You want classification? Okay, okay.
Yes. Thank you, sir.
This is not only one species, not only one order. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Different species, different. Okay. Okay.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, why few mushrooms die soon and few will be living for few days, more days, and few will be dying soon? Why is that, sir?
Because mushrooms are very, very delicate and very sensitive, are very susceptible to all microbes or all other bacteria or other microorganisms. So that's why they are very easily contaminated. After maturation, or within a week or 3 to 4 days, whenever we are going to cutting of the fleshes of the mushrooms, whenever we are within a week, we are transported or marketing, or we are even though consumption, otherwise it will go into easily contaminated and going to decay or decompose very easily. Why? Because it is very delicate and very sensitive and susceptible to easily contaminated with other microbes. Okay, other microbes means all saprophytes, whether the bacteria or other fungi or other fungal spores also going to decaying of these mushrooms. Am I clear?
Yes, sir. All the mushrooms also, they are like that only, sir?
No. Actually, all the mushrooms are the same, but poisonous mushrooms are capable for the surviving more than compared to edible mushrooms. Because they are wild. They are wild in nature. They are not in the touch of the human beings. They are not the supervision of the human beings. So without supervision of the human beings, they are grown wildly. So they are grown in the natural settings. So that's why they are capable to show their, what we can say, the resistance. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Am I clear?
Yes, sir. For these edible mushrooms, there's no other process to store them, sir.
Okay, you are absolutely correct, Amma, but it will only take 2 to 3 days, or within a week we are ready to store. But more than 7 days, it is impossible to store, because it will easily go, what we can say, that it is a very delicate food organism, you know. So that's why within a week definitely we will going to consume, otherwise it will going to decompose or contaminated with other microbes.
So there is no other process also, no, sir, to store them?
Yes. You are absolutely correct, Amma. Actually, day before yesterday, I hope we are discussed about the first mushroom, that is the Padistra mushroom, you know, Valveriella valvaci. So that mushrooms, we are stored in different manner, you know, chutneys. So use oils and what we can say, that's in wet condition, we can add oil and salt and other what we can say, that stored components or spices mingled with spices that can used as a chutneys or pickle. Even though in dry condition, in dry condition in the presence of the sunlight. So it will go into mana varugulu antam chustunnara meeru tomato gaani vankayalu gaani meeru enda pettesi baaga
yes.
So like that in dry condition also we are stored some more days.
Okay, I mean, sir, in wet conditions we can't store.
Yeah, yeah, no, okay. No, no. Yeah, you know, wet condition also in pickles or chutney, making of the mushroom chutney, making of the mushroom pickle. Definitely, okay. We can store. We can add the oil, some more oil, extra oil, oil and salt content. Okay, and even though some of the spices, add ginger and garlic, even the what we can say in our kitchen, our mother, our. A woman, they are making of the what we can say that chutney or manam em antam manam pickles and but aa roopamlo manam nilo chesukovachu
sir. Anybody? Sir, one explain fourth slide lo sir, I did not listen.
I'm not audible amma, please once you
once explain the fourth slide lo sir.
Yeah, okay, no problem, I will explain. No problem.
Sorry, sir.
No problem. Okay, it is visible.
Yes, sir.
This one.
You do not know, sir.
Poisonous mushrooms.
I cannot see, sir.
This is not visible. The slide is not visible.
Yes, sir.
Okay. One second. Now. Now it's visible.
No, sir.
No.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah. You want poisonous mushrooms or edible mushrooms?
Poisonous.
Okay. This one.
Yes, sir.
So death cap, Amanita phalloides, Amanita virosa. Important, very important in competitive examination. Also, they are asking. Amanita phalloides, Amanita virosa, Amanita pantherina, Amanita muscaria. These are the four Amanita species are very, very highly poisonous mushrooms. Dinne manam marana makutamu, okay na? Okay. Marana devata, leda nashana devaduta. Okay. Pilustam anamata. Right?
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Right. Is there any doubt, anybody? Okay. I will stop here. Tomorrow sharp 3 p.m. we will meet. Okay. In our Google. Okay, madam. Any?
Yes, okay, thank you, sir.
Madam, can I leave?
Very interesting. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Very interesting and interactive session today.
Very good, amma. Thank you. Thank because you. Of your you are enjoyingly participation is important. I am not a supremacy person. Whenever you listen carefully or you are able to understand. The information related to what we have shared the knowledge, that is important. So your participation, your actively participation, you are interact with me, that is important. So that's why I'm very thankful to you. And also madam, can I leave?
Okay sir.
Right.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you,
ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, girls. Okay. Bye, girls.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Bye, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.